Good morning, I'm Sunitra Chaudhary, political editor of the Hindustan Times, bringing you all that you need to know about COVID-19 on Friday, the 19th of June. First up, a look at the numbers. In just the last 24 hours, there have been almost 14,000 new cases. In fact, 13,893 to be precise. The total number of deaths from COVID-19 stand at 12,605. Which brings us to our top story, which is the one that many of you have been asking for, that how is it we only give the number of deaths and the number of total infections? What about the recovery? So here is what that data says. In total, there have been more than 200,000 recoveries. So out of the 381,000 infections that are there across the country and have been there since the time the coronavirus started spreading in the country, more than 200,000 people have recovered from it. And if you look at how it stands globally, well, then global rate of recovery is 55%. Ours is just marginally less at 53.2%. Now, which are the states that have the highest recoveries? They're also the states actually that have the highest number of cases. So Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, while topping the charts in being badly impacted, also have the absolute highest number of recoveries. So that's the data. Now for the not so pleasant data, and that of the positivity rate going up. Now the positivity rate is the number of people tested, how many of them are testing positive. And for a lot of the cities and states, they are rising in the last 1 month, showing the extensive spread of coronavirus in the last 1 month. So for examples, if you look at the number of samples tested in Haryana and Delhi and the number testing positive, then the positivity rate there in Delhi has gone from 7%. So out of all the tests that were done, initially only 7% were testing positive. Now 31% are testing positive. And if you look at the positivity rate for Haryana, which is also very high, it's gone from 1% to 10%. And doctors say that Delhi's figures show that there is community spread in Delhi, in the capital, even though it is something that the central authorities deny. They don't say ICMR has not acknowledged the spread, the community spread of the coronavirus in the country. The next story that we have for you is, what is it that we can do, what authorities can do to crack down and stop the spread? Well, one of the things that the police is doing is finding people who are spitting or they're not wearing their mask or not maintaining social distancing. Now, just to give an instance of how this is working, in just the last 2 days, Delhi has fined 2,700 people for not maintaining this. So for not wearing masks, for not maintaining social distancing. And initially they were also filing FIRs, but they feel that the fining system works. So 2,700 people fine either 500 rupees, or if they've done it before, that means for subsequent fines, they're being fined 1,000 rupees. So that's one way of controlling and cracking down on the spread. The next story comes from Kerala, where the authorities are in a bit of a standoff with the central government because they're saying that those who are coming back to the state have to have a COVID-free certificate. And this is something which has held up the Vande Bharat flights of people coming back, because Kerala, which had been doing very well, has been seeing rising cases because of those who are coming back. And that's why they have initiated this. Now they've offered TruNAT tests. So the test which tests for tuberculosis, they're saying that they are going to send these test kits to the embassies abroad so that those flights that are coming back to Kerala, that everyone can be tested. Why these particular tests? Because these ones give their results in 1 hour or 2 hours. So they feel that it will be quite practical to carry out these tests and only send back those that are clear and not corona positive. And what about the ones who are positive? That they're saying that the center should handle. So this is something perhaps which has to be sorted out between the two. And finally, there has been a lot of concern of late about online learning and how many people, how democratic is it? How many children can actually gain from it? Well, there's a study now that's been done at more than 1,000 schools in the capital. The schools are Delhi government schools, and they found that only 6 out of 10 have been able to access the system. And this is while it wasn't just online learning here. They also had an IVR method for those who may not have smartphones, and that shows over 40% children being completely left out. When they looked at it, they found that 23% of children, in fact, were not traceable at all. The school authorities couldn't get in touch with them. And the authorities say this is probably because they were facing too many economic hardships, or perhaps there was reverse migration that we've seen among the migrant community here in India ever since the lockdown has been brought in. So these are the stories for today. You can keep tracking them on HindustanTimes.com.